You know, Doris, we've been hanging out and dating for so long. And I really like you a lot, so I want to ask you this, will you marry me?
Oh my god, yes, you are a really nice guy, and I would love to marry someone who gets and understands me well.
Oh my gosh, can you believe it, Mason? Our daughter is going to get married for the first time. I am so happy for her.
Same, honey. I am so glad that she has married a nice man unlike her ex who would get drunk and beg repeatedly to take her back multiple times.
It's so good to see our best friend Doris getting married.
Yeah, I agree.
Amazing. Boris finally knows how to cope whenever Corys is bothering him.
So Torius, I can see that your brother will have a happy future. What do you think it will be like?
I can't really tell people's futures, sweetie. But I can imagine his future being him having a shot to his chest and a dagger in his eye.
Mom and Dad, why did both of your stupid asses decide to bring me to this stupid wedding? Like I would ever want to see Boris get married to the girl I had a crush on first. Doris is such a moron for breaking up with me to marry Boris. But this is mostly Boris's fault for exposing me for what I did. I'm so gonna get them both for this.
Corys, the reason we have brought you here is because of how miserable you have made his teen and childhood.
Yes, and please don't ruin your brother's wedding. Just like how you have affected how he feels about himself thanks to you abusing him a lot.
Thank you all for coming to this wedding. We are proudly here to see these two, Boris and Doris, get married. They have been together since preschool and have been through some challenges in their life, such as depression and abuse, but did not let that get between them. Do you, Boris, take Doris to be your wedded wife? To cherish in love and in friendship, in strength and in weakness, in success and in disappointment, to love her faithfully today, tomorrow, and for as long as the two of you shall live?
I do.
Do you, Doris, take Boris to be your wedded husband? To cherish in love and in friendship, in strength and in weakness, in success and in disappointment, to love him today, tomorrow, and for as long as the two of you shall live?
I do.
I now pronounce you, husband and wife. You may kiss the bride.
Gee, Doris, you've sure gained some weight over the past months. What's going on?
To be completely honest, Boris, I do not know. I think we should go and see a doctor.
Yeah, that sounds like a pretty good idea. Hello, nurse. My wife here seems to have a big bump on her stomach. Do you know what might be the effect of this?
Sir, your wife seems to be pregnant, and by the looks of it, it might be twins.
Boris, did you hear that? We're gonna have kids. I'm gonna be a mommy.
And I'm going to be a daddy.
Now before you go, Doris, I want you to eat well, monitor your baby's movements, stay active, and always take care of your mental health.
Now Doris, I know this pregnancy thing may seem hard to you, but don't worry, I'll help you get through it.
Thank you so much. That's so nice of you. Boris, I think my water just broke. That means the babies are coming. So get me straight to the hospital.
Okay, but I've got to finish my—
Did I stutter? I said get in the car, now. Boris, the babies are going to come out any minute now. Hurry up!
Calm down, woman. We're almost there. Please tell me she is going to be okay, nurse.
Don't worry, sir. She is. All she needs to do is push a bit harder.
I'm trying. Really? Hard. Ugh. Wait, is it coming out?
I think so, Mrs. Anderson. Congratulations, Doris. You have male baby twins. What would you like to name them?
Oh my gosh. They look so adorable.
Let's name the one in the yellow blanket Caillou.
And the one in the gray blanket, Classic Caillou.
Now taking care of them involves diaper changing, feeding them, and putting them to sleep even when they cry. Good luck taking care of these two.
Hi, my name is Caillou. You can describe me as a sensitive, but easygoing person.
Ha, pranked you again.
That's classic Caillou. He is what daddy calls a handful, and I can't really blame him, because dealing with a loud, obnoxious, troublemaker who pulls pranks and causes trouble every day is pretty hard to deal with.
Caillou, are you alright? Boris, come over here. Caillou is in pain.
That's mommy. She's sweet and supportive. Sometimes so sweet that she can spoil classic Caillou at times, which can be a problem.
Doris, what did you call me here for?
Daddy and I are really close. Not only because he protects me from near-death experiences that classic Caillou can cause, but it's also because he is always there for me when I am feeling down or upset.
Another boxing glove gadget, classic Caillou.
Yeah. Not to mention he is also the one responsible for putting gooey slime all over my bed.
That's Rosie. She, just like me, is against classic Caillou's troublemaking. Yeah, and he was the one who put laxatives in my food last time.
You know, classic Caillou, I know that I've talked about this before, but why do you always have to pull pranks on your brother and sister? You know they don't like it.
I know they don't like it, Daddy, but that doesn't mean I can't do it.
Just because it's an advantage to you, doesn't mean it's an advantage to anyone else.
Well, I don't care about anyone else.
What I am trying to say is, pranking and making fun of others isn't funny, especially to them, so please change your act.
Yes, please do so.
Well, it looks like the school bus is here. Bye, kids.
Bye, mommy and daddy.
See, Boris. At least classic Caillou was good enough to say goodbye to you and me. Now you can say goodbye to him back.
Okay, have a good day.
You too, asshole.
Yep, I'm definitely going to talk to him when he gets back from preschool.
Huh. I wonder what this thing is.
These are my friends, Leo, Clementine, and Sarah. They are really nice as they are always by my side when I need them. We've been best friends since we met at my preschool on the first day.
Oh, hi Caillou. Peppa is sitting here today because of no seats being left for her.
What? But I usually sit.
I'm sitting here, so go find another one.
Fine, I'll go.
Hey Caillou, saved you a seat.
That's Dora. She's honestly the sweetest and kindest person I have ever met in this preschool. She always blushes when she's around me. I kind of wonder why. Maybe it's because she has a crush on me, which I've always known.
So Caillou, how's life?
Oh, life is pretty good. But I have got to say, dealing with a brother like classic Caillou can be pretty difficult. I mean, he pulls pranks on every person that criticizes him.
Oh please, you're being a bit too dramatic. I do the exact same when people mess with me. In fact, he's my BFF.
There is a lot of obstacles I have in life, such as being bullied, but people like you, Dora, make me forget all about them.
Hi Caillou, sorry for replacing you with Peppa. We thought she was going to be pleasant, but boy were we wrong when she talked non-stop about teasing her brother in muddy puddles.
Thanks for the apology, Leo, but that's not the point.
What is it then, Caillou? You can tell us, we're your friends.
Okay, I'll tell you, because you guys are the only ones who I can trust. It's Dora.
Dora, have you two finally gone out yet?
Not really. She's been making a lot of moves on me lately ever since her and Little Bill broke up.
What kind of moves?
Well, every time we were near Little Bill, or alone, she would rub my head, massage my feet, and even hug and kiss me.
That sounds kind of weird, but that must mean she likes-
Hey!
You said Dora was doing all of that stuff to you, and not to me?
Dora broke up with you a year ago, remember?
You didn't have to remind me. Listen, just because Dora broke up with me, doesn't mean that you all of a sudden get to steal all the attention from her. As you get all the love from her, while I on the other hand, get mean comments from her. I'm just letting you know, Caillou Anderson, if you ever, and I mean, ever, step a centimeter near Dora, or lay a finger on her, then I am going to beat you, along with my friends. So stay away from Dora. She's mine.
School bell. You got lucky.
But don't say I didn't warn you.
Caillou, are you okay?
I'm fine, I'm fine. Let's just go to class.
Okay, class. Today we are going to be learning about a feeling in which we have deep feelings for a certain person, place, or thing. Love.
Oh boy, I'm going to love this lesson.
Love can mean a strong affection to a certain thing or person and to have a strong interest in something. For example, if a guy were to show an affection to a woman, that would
Hey
be
dude,
an
you all right?
Or if a relative were to love
are you gonna
another,
even listen to
that
me?
Would also be love. Is there any questions so far?
Ow! What the hell, classic Caillou? Why the heck did you do that?
Well, I had no choice. It was the only way to get your attention. Now tell me what's wrong.
Fine. If it will make you not smack me, Dora, that football-headed idiot, keeps on spending more time with Caillou than with me.
I know, right? Despite the fact that Dora and I are really close friends, every time we're near Caillou, she always gets distracted from talking to me to either flirt or smooch him.
He's been getting all of the attention from Dora, and we have to put a stop to this. We have to get revenge.
Why not just beat him up?
That's what I do when he gets on my nerves.
You know what? I will do that. Let's both beat up Caillou after school. Meet me in the hallway later this afternoon.
Got it.
Hey, kitty.
Oh, hi, Dora. What's up?
I really like the way you raised your hand to explain how love can work in class. You are so smart. And when you are smart, it really makes me love you so much.
I really like the compliment you've given me, Dora. But now I have to go home. Mommy and Daddy are probably waiting for me outside.
Wait, Caillou. You don't understand. I truly, truly love you. Like, really much. So much that I just wanna kiss you.
Dora, I'm not really sure about this. What if somebody sees and the news spreads wide around?
Shh.
No need to fret about anything. Let the kissing do all the work.
He is so going down.
Caillou, we had our first kiss. That was so amazing. Anyway, I have to get going. Adios, Caillou.
Bye, Dora. Wow, my first kiss. It's hard to believe it. Well, time to get going. Hello guys.
Don't hello guys us. We saw what you were doing with Dora near the lockers, making out.
Well, actually, she kind of wanted this to happen.
Shut up.
Ever since Dora broke up with me, you've stolen all the attention from her. And it makes me sad just seeing you smooching her in the halls.
Oh, I'm so sorry you guys felt that way about me and Dora having a relationship. I didn't know you guys were being a-
Get him!
Get back here.
Thank you.
Caillou, 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 are you okay? Please wake up. Wake up, Caillou.
Daddy, I'm in so much pain.
Oh no, this is worse than I thought. Come on, let's get you home. Now Caillou, tell me what happened. I was really worried sick when I heard your teacher tell me you've gotten beaten up. Now tell me, how did this situation start?
Well, it started when Dora and I kissed in the halls after her admitting to having a crush on me. Then classic Caillou and Little Bill must have overheard the conversation because they've been angry at me for Dora paying more attention to me than to them. So they beat me up. This is all my fault. I should have never kissed Dora. Now thanks to me, classic Caillou and Little Bill are gonna give me infinite beatings forever.
There, there. No need to be so hard on yourself, kid. I'm here for you. It's not your fault this whole situation has happened.
Really?
Yes, you see, son, in life not all people are going to give you respect, such as your brother, Little Bill, and Arthur. But you are glad to have people like me, who are always gonna be there for you, no matter what happens. Now how about we go downstairs to the living room to watch your favorite movie? It will cheer you up.
Oh goody.
Wait up, Caillou. I haven't chosen the movie yet.
Oh, that stupid Caillou. Always getting the attention. Always having positive outcomes after I give him negative ones. I hate him so much.
Yep. And Rosie hears the same thing every single day.
Hey, I didn't ask you to come eavesdropping on my conversation. Go away.
For your information, Rosie wasn't trying to eavesdrop on your rant about Caillou, but rather to tell you that each troublemaking deed you do and even the littlest can get you in big trouble. And unless you want Daddy to punish you even longer, it is recommended that you don't do that deed in order to stay out of trouble.
Okay, Rosie, whatever you say.
I didn't mean to get mean or anything. I was just trying to recommend you to stay out of trouble. Especially considering all the dangerous pranks you've done.
Hey, smarty pants.
What?
Answer this question. How much water can you handle while being stuck in a toilet?
Wait, what are you?
Mommy, Daddy, help me. Rosie's stuck in a toilet. Classic Caillou. Get Rosie out of here.
It was so nice of you to cheer Caillou up like that by putting on a movie for him.
Yeah, I know. Anything for my boy.
Boris, honey, are you okay? What's wrong?
It's not you. It's just I need to have a talk with Classic Caillou about his behavior lately.
Daddy's been acting kind of different lately, hasn't he?
Daddy may not know why Little Bill and Classic Caillou hate me so much. But I do. It all started a year ago when I was 3. It was my first day of preschool, along with Classic Caillou's, but we were very nervous to get in.
Come on, guys. Don't be nervous. It's just your first day of school. You don't even know if something bad is gonna happen. You might be able to make friends.
I wanna stay home with you, Mommy. I'm too nervous to go to school. Me too. Take both of us home, Mommy. I don't wanna go to school.
Don't be scared, you guys. Your father had the same experience as you guys did. But as soon as he stepped in the building, he forgot about what he was worrying about.
That doesn't apply to us. Now get your stupid red blouse wearing back in the car and take us home.
Oh my god. Such naughty language I am hearing. Classic Caillou, you do not speak to Mommy like that. Especially with that type of language.
I'm sorry, Mommy.
It's okay. I'll let you off with a warning. But before you go to school, I recommend you two to be on your best behavior at school today. Don't let your teacher, who is a best friend of mine, make a phone call home saying that you misbehaved in class. Now have a good day, boys.
Bye, Mommy.
Mommy, Daddy, help me. Rosie's stuck in a toilet. Help me, help me, help me.
Oh my god. Rosie? Rosie, are you all-
Oh hell no.
What happened?
Daddy, classic Caillou was mean to Rosie by putting her in a toilet after he got mad at her for giving him a recommendation.
Oh Teddy, you cannot believe how weak Caillou was during that fight me and Little Bill gave him. He didn't even try defending himself. What a weakling. Right Teddy? Well screw you Teddy, it's not my problem you don't have a good taste in my sense of humor.
Uh-oh.
Ha, thought you could get yourself out of this one? You nearly killed Rosie. Ugh, now Rosie's gotta go take a bath. Rosie smells like toilet water.
Daddy,
Classic Caillou, I think it's time we had a talk.
About what, Daddy?
About your behavior lately, how your pranks have become more dangerous and how your behavior became more bad. Look son, when I was your age, I used to be just like you, cute, energetic, and full of ideas. But as your father, I want the best for you. I don't want you to end up being a juvenile troublesome stuck-up annoying jerk like your uncle. I want you to grow up to be a healthy and non-spoiled person to be around.
Daddy, how could you say that about me? Are you saying I'm not perfect?
No. It's not that at all. Nobody has to be perfect at anything. No one. We are all human. What I am trying to say is a recommendation to try and improve your behavior or not make your pranks too destructive or dangerous in order to not get yourself in serious trouble and to keep your family safe. That's all I had to say. Thanks for listening.